गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर एडुकेशन ऑनलाइन क्लास। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड डिस्कसिंग द एंशिएंट इंडियन एडुकेशन एंड ओवर देयर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द कॉमन फीचर्स ऑफ ऑल द सिस्टम ऑफ एडुकेशन एंड वी हैव लर्न दैट रिलीजियस एंड रिलीजियस थॉट्स थिंकिंग एंड रिलीजियस रिलीजियन वॉज द बेसिस ऑफ एडुकेशन and depending on different types of according to the thought, according to the thinking of the gurus, different stages and different steps of and system of education was developed in ancient education. So here, as I have told you, that you are going to learn Vedic, Brahmanic, Buddhist and finally Muslim education. So we have already started with Vedic education and aims of education and forms of education, and along with that the teacher's significance of guru we have learned. Today we are going to start with the method of teaching. Now see, as we have read that the method was basically dependent on oral instructions, and the teachers used to read the hymns and the students used to repeat, and there was strict instruction not to disobey the teacher, and there was strict instruction to follow, because in ancient time the pronunciation was also very important, but the way you are pronouncing was also considered very important. So significance of the method of teaching: basically verbal in nature, and much stress was laid on correct pronunciation, as I have told you just now, of the hymns taught to the students. So the hymns or the rhymes or the oral instructions, poems, or the topic of study which was given to them, which was provided to them, they were instructed to listen it properly and to repeat it after the guru will complete reading it out. And why the pronunciation was very much important? Because pronunciation, it will help you to hear, listen better, and you need to learn it, how to pronounce as well. Next is course of study. In Vedic period, the following subjects of the course of study were taught: logic, jyotish, grammar, siksha, chanda, nirukta and religious. So these are the different topics which were taught in the Vedic educational system. Next we come in Brahma Sangha. Now what is a Sangha? Institutions like seminars where educates got opportunity to achieve their quest for higher knowledge. Means this Brahmana Sangha, where the great educators and the person who were eager to learn a better learning, they used to come closer to each other, and over their seminars, discussions and debates were being organized, where they used to assemble each other in and at that time it was open for all caste also, not only for Vedic thinkers or Vedic followers. It was open for all those who were interested to listen higher level of knowledge were always welcomed over there. And moreover, the education was open to all, and all were entertained, but before entertaining they have to follow some rules and regulations, and they have to promise that they will follow the guru's instruction and they must obey what instructions were provided. So before entering the class, they must understand that what is the meaning of Vedic system of education, what is the significance, what life they have to live, and the main thing which was considered, the other caste must follow as the guru wants to teach, as the guru want to instruct you, as they want to follow the each and every point they have to form. So this is all about Brahmana Sangha, and over there the oral instructions were given, just like the other students, those who were under the Vedic institutions, those who are learning, the same has to be followed by the really different the people, those who are coming from different religions. Next day we will start discussing the remaining two points, that is the woman education and some special feature about the Vedic education. We will finish in the next part and then we will proceed with the Brahmanic system of education. Thank you very much.